When you're thirsty, it means that you are already dehydrated. Severe untreated dehydration can lead to a coma. Without water, humans can survive for only about 3 days. So, we can say that water is pretty important for our body, but why is that so from a science perspective? Going back in time, the first forms of life started to develop inside the water. The atmospheric conditions and gases that were present on Earth stimulated the formation of different biomolecules. So, water is essential for pretty much every metabolic process in the body. Then, it is of no surprise that our anatomy consists of more than 50% water. But when we say body water, what does that really mean? The total amount consists of two compartments: intracellular, inside the cells, and extracellular, outside the cells, as in blood and fluid in between cells. Movement of water molecules through a selectively permeable membrane, such as a cell membrane, from a less concentrated region into a more concentrated one is known as osmosis. By this process, water tends to equalize the concentration of solute on the two sides of the membrane. As an illustration, we can use electrolytes. Electrolytes are ions such as sodium, potassium, magnesium, calcium, phosphate, etc. Lack of water leads to an increase in the concentration of electrolytes in the extracellular compartment. In order to maintain equilibrium, water molecules move outside the cells, causing them to shrink. The percentage of water and concentration of electrolytes are of great importance in regulating the blood volume as well as blood pressure. An overall concentration of all dissolved substances, such as electrolytes for example, in the blood is known as blood osmolarity. Our thirst response is in close relationship with changes in blood osmolarity, as that reflects our state of hydration. Let's say for example that you have been exercising hard and sweating a lot. As a result, you lost a great amount of water and now you're thirsty. What exactly happened? By losing water from your body, the blood volume decreases and becomes more concentrated. As blood osmolarity increases, water moves from the intracellular to the extracellular compartment, causing shrinkage of a specialized group of cells called osmoreceptors. They are located in the thirst center of the brain, in the hypothalamus. They monitor the blood osmolarity, and when there is an increase, it triggers the hypothalamus to transmit signals and to in turn make us drink water. By drinking, water comes back into the cells, the electrolyte equilibrium, blood volume and blood pressure are established again, and our body can function properly. So, these receptors can help us know if we are thirsty, but what happens when water losses are greater than water intake? We lose water constantly through sweating, breathing, and urination. Being dehydrated often and for a long time can cause severe consequences. A disruption in electrolyte balance, blood pressure, and blood volume alters your body on different levels. In short, the deficit of water influences the proper functioning of kidneys and the cardiovascular system, and as an outcome, you may feel dry mouth, headache, tiredness, confusion, weakness, decreased urine output, nausea, muscle cramps, and heart palpitations. As we can see, water is the most important nutrient, and our understanding of water requirements is crucial. As water deficit can have a huge impact on the quality of life, we need to adjust our intake of water in order to come back into a balanced state. So, remember to drink water daily and to maintain your hydration. Thank you for watching. Check out the video we made on stress by clicking on the screen, and check out our Instagram page, Doron's Academy, where we post daily. See you next time.